afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to the concert hall at the University of Glasgow. Just a quick one from me. We have a squeaky door at the moment, so we have pulled the inner doors over on that side. So if any of you came in that way, you can actually use the toilets on that side and leave that side. We're going to keep those shut in case we hear it during the performance, which, you know, we don't want. So, so I'm going to hand over for the introduction.
Hello everybody, good afternoon and welcome. And this is my first time doing this kind of opening, so I'm quite nervous. My name is Vivian, I'm a fourth year student doing English literature and music. And so today we're delighted to have the amazing Baba Yaga duo with Karen Dufour on saxophone and Gwen Sinclair on harp. Please could you put your phones away for the entire concert and just enjoy the music.
that piece was by a German composer, Gustav Bunker, and he actually met Adolf Sax, the founder, the inventor of the saxophone, and he was so taken by the instrument and meeting Adolf Sax that he then went back and bought 8 saxophones. So that's more saxophones than I own. And he then went on and dedicated a lot of his creative output to the classical saxophone. And he's quoted as saying it's an instrument of beautiful and noble sound. He didn't say anything about the harp.
He did write very well for it.
So our next piece is by the Scottish arranged by the Scottish composer Eddie Maguire, and we're delighted to have Eddie here in the room with us. He's always a strong supporter of musicians coming out of the conservatoire and the universities here. So we're actually going to invite him up to introduce our next piece. Thank you, Eddie.
Well, the title of the next piece is 3 traditional pieces, but the surprise it will be for you that the traditional pieces are actually 3 Chinese traditional pieces, not my usual Scottish pieces that I arrange sometimes. And then you'll be curious to know why I was doing this. And that is I play, as well as being a composer, I play with a Scottish folk music group, and that's the Whistle Binkies, and we went over to China in 1991 and did a 2-week tour of the cities playing Scottish folk music, but we also had to perform an encore with local musicians. And the year before that, I'd traveled there and arranged this tour, and Mr. Zhao Yao Kun was an arhu player who recommended that we use as encores 2 of the tunes you're about to hear. And the second and the third of the 3 pieces are the encores we played in China in 1991. And that second piece is Purple Bamboo Melody, Zi Zhu Diao, and I hope I say that correctly. And the second and final piece is Song of Happiness, which is Si Yang Yang. And those are the pieces we joined with Chinese musicians on that tour. But the first piece brings me back to the fact that when I was a student in London at the Academy of Music there, I bought my first bamboo flute in a shop in Camden Town, and it was a Xiao instrument, an end-blown bamboo flute. Now I play the Dietze, which is the normally transverse bamboo flute. And the famous rendition of the first piece you're about to hear, which is called The Little Shepherd, Xiao Mouton, I think it's pronounced, was made very famous by a flute player who died just last year at the age of nearly 100. And you'll see this piece on YouTube if you look up The Little Shepherd, or The Little Herding Boy, sometimes it's called. And it's a lonely melody in probably the steppes and the prairies of central China that you might find in the past a shepherd playing his flute. And I think the ideal sound that you get from saxophone and harp is a good rendition of that melody. So here are the 3 pieces: The Little Shepherd, Purple Bamboo Melody, which is a celebration of spring, and Si Yang Yang, which is quite used to this day in celebrations in China. So enjoy these 3 traditional Chinese pieces. Thank you.
Thank you.
completely different. I'm afraid we're going to abandon tunefulness for a moment. We have a piece written by a composer in Los Angeles. His name is Patrick O'Malley. And it's called Thaumaturgy. So it's about
magic.
Sorcery.
Yeah.
Things like that. Now, we were in touch with Patrick O'Malley himself in organising this. There is more, which we will add at some point, but at the moment this is the first movement. It does involve some extended techniques for both instruments. So this is where we have a bit of fun, and this is where I had to invest in a brand new piece of metal. So for other things where I've needed a piece of metal on the harp, which does happen, I've used a metal tuning key. However, on this occasion I decided my metal tuning key wasn't making the right sound. So for a while I tried a screwdriver, and then I was a bit nervous about using the screwdriver because if I drop it, it's going to go straight through the soundboard. The same thing might happen with this. It's not quite as pointy on the end as a screwdriver would be, but this is from a triangle, which I ordered last week. And I'm just going to use the beater. But you will find out how I'm going to use it. I'm going to change pitches of strings with it. I'm going to do some glissandi with it. I'm going to hit the strings with it. We've also got what we call a thunder effect on the harp. That's just where I hit the strings as hard as I can. And it's all a bit dramatic. What else have I got? Some falling hail effect is using the back of the nails to do a glissandi. And Karen also has some fun things to do.
Yeah, so nothing as drastic as taking a metal stick to my instrument. But yeah, so the saxophone, a lot of flutter tonguing is used. So it's when you're rolling your tongue and playing the note, and some multiphonic in this movement. So it's where you're essentially creating the effect of playing more than one note, and also going up pretty high on the saxophone, which I'm not going to do because I've never done it before.
We weren't.
Thank you.
multi-instrumentalist and composer Yusuf Latif. So Latif was a saxophonist and flute player, along with composing in lots of different idioms. So he composed a lot of jazz music, but he also went into orchestral composition and film soundtrack. And he also, in 1949, I believe, was invited to play with Dizzy Gillespie's band. So he had quite a varied career during his time. And one of his compositions is this piece, Romance, for soprano saxophone and harp. And it's in three movements, and each movement has its own sort of distinct character.
Thank you.
At the beginning of the service on the evening. So before I forget, I do need to retune a string. Our bottom two strings on the harp don't have pedal action, so if we need something different, let's change it. just watch. I should say, this was obviously written originally for cello and orchestra.
Yeah, we did the arrangement quite a few years ago now for saxophone.
Thank you.
It's been lovely to play for you, and thank you to Kathy and of her team for looking after us today as well. So our last piece is by an American composer, Natalie Moller, and she is someone that is very passionate about intersections and combination of music, theatre, dance, and video games, and film as well. And a lot of her work is inspired by nature, and this piece begins with an undulating harp intro, and then it sort of starts to move about lots of different time signatures and just kind of play around.
Oh.